the Interior and Local Government Department not recognizing the Cebu local government's decision to scrap the mask mandate in the province. DILG Secretary Eduardo Año said existing protocols dictate face masks can only be taken off when eating or while participating in sports activities in well-ventilated venues. He adds, police will continue to apprehend violators of those guidelines. On Thursday, Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia issued an executive order saying face masks are no longer mandatory in outdoor settings. She cited the improved COVID situation in the province as her basis for easing the mask mandate. Joining us now to weigh in on the issue is the spokesperson of DOH Central Visayas, Dr. Mary Jean Loreche. Dr. Loreche, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Yes, magandang hapon din po sa ating lahat.
Kasasabi lang po natin, kababalita lang natin that Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia cited the improved COVID situation in the province as her basis for easing the mask mandate. But what is your data telling you? Is the COVID situation there in Cebu really improved at this point that the province can do away with masks? Go ahead, doctor.
Yeah, thank you so much for inviting me so we can clarify certain issues. Apparently, this is the hottest right now. Yes, that is correct. Based on our data on the ground, we really have very much, improved number of cases. Meaning to say, we have seen no increase in the number of cases. As a matter of fact, even our capacity utilization rates are very, very low, which is in the safe zone. Secondly, we'd like to correct something, no? Apparently, it is misunderstood because apparently the EO, the executive order, really touched on outdoor activities. So these are areas like the beaches, the beach resorts, even the mountainous areas where you want to enjoy and be, at peace and be with nature, wherein you are actually given the option not to wear your face mask.
And that doesn't clash at all with IATF guidelines?
I don't see any disharmony there, if you really look at it. When you define well-ventilated areas, an outdoor area, that's a well-ventilated area. Secondly, in the EO, it was clearly stated that in enclosed spaces, where people are, there's a lot more, crowded spaces, people who are symptomatic, they are actually advised, to continue on wearing their face mask. So here, Carmina, I think there is that shift, that paradigm shift, wherein we are now giving the opportunity for people to know their risk of whether they should be wearing their face mask in an outdoor setting or whether they will not be using it.
But what about in crowded outdoor areas? For example, public markets. It's outdoor, but it's crowded. What's the guideline regarding that?
I believe that one, it is now incumbent upon the individual or of the constituent whether to continue on wearing the face mask in crowded areas, even if this is an outdoor activity. But then again, a person will have to know and understand his or her risk as to whether you are fully vaccinated and boosted, you are not, feeling unwell, so you know that you do have to be able to continue on wearing your face mask, depending on how you assess also your capacity to be exposed and to contract the disease.
And this confidence in the people to sort of discern for themselves, this didn't happen overnight. This of course, served as the basis, or did it serve as the basis of for months and months of health officials monitoring, surveilling how the public has been adhering to COVID protocols?
Again, you know that we have to also consider that the human nature, a person, when given that opportunity to become very lax and overly confident, despite the fact that he or she understands the danger of the situation, again, that's another, aspect that we have to look into. But if you really study the executive order of the governor, it was also clearly stated there which areas you would be, given that option. It's a choice, really. It's trying to give you that opportunity to also decide for yourself and not just you know, bank on all the government rules and regulations. Hmm.
But make no mistake about it, when you talk about indoor activities, masks would still be have to be worn.
Yes, definitely indoor activities, particularly if these are not well ventilated. Because there are indoor activities that have well ventilation, all right? So we have your carbon dioxide monitors, you have your HEPA filters, you have your air changes that you have to determine. So all of this will have to be taken into consideration also.
Remind us again, Cebu is under alert level 1, correct?
That's correct. There are areas that are under alert level 1. There is also there are also LGUs or municipalities that are still, you know, under alert level 2.
Mm. We heard from the palace recently that under alert level 1, there's going to be 100% capacity. Only proof of full vaccination will be needed. We also talked to a health expert saying that, you know, that has to be redefined. What does full vaccination mean? Does it mean just the first two doses or plus one, including the booster shots? How is the province dealing with this?
That's correct. That has been cascaded to us already, particularly, you know, in terms of redefining what full vaccination means. But we know also that people are, you know, everything regarding vaccination is voluntary. Our full vaccination status here, coverage in terms of the general population for the entire region, is actually very good. It is with the senior citizens. There are certain areas where the senior citizens' full vaccination status is still being ramped up. As to the booster shots, again, we are still trailing behind what is the target. But I believe that we also have to consider here the active immunity that we have gotten from those who have been exposed or who had gotten COVID. So all of this, you know, has to be taken into account when we talk about how are we going to move forward with the new normal.
Are you concerned, Dr. Loreche, that, you know, moving forward with a new normal, living with the virus, because that's essentially what you're trying to do now there in the province, right? And also the drive for booster shots, are you concerned that, you know, you're giving conflicting signals here to the public? Because on one hand, you're saying it's okay, it's up to you to discern, COVID situation has improved, but we still have to meet our numbers with regard to booster vaccinations, doctor.
There's no disharmony there, ma'am. Because if you look at this, this executive order is good for the province of Cebu. We are not touching the three highly urbanized cities where these areas are densely populated. I mean, these are, you know, have a lot more of people gatherings and a lot more of activities going on. So that's one. Second, we have to understand also that although we are driving for the booster shots to rise in terms of number of acceptance from our people, but we cannot also rely and depend only on the reopening of all our activities because people wouldn't want to become given, you know, wouldn't want to accept the booster shot.
Yeah, because the message might be everything is okay already. Why would I even have to go and get that booster shot? You know, the province is easing up restrictions, and yet there's this booster vaccination drive. It might affect the person in that way that, you know, everything is fine and dandy now, so why would I even go in for that booster shot?
There is that possibility that there will be issues and concerns regarding the booster shot, but currently we will just stay on hold on I mean, we'll stay on track on the contents of the executive order of the governor, which is allowing the, you know, giving the option for one person not to wear the face mask in stipulated areas.
All right. I want to talk about the booster situation there. How many booster shots are still available for the province, and how much is expiring soon?
Currently, based on our logistics from our cold chain in the Department of Health Region 7, for the month of June, we do not have expiring, you know, vaccines. I believe it will be towards the end of July that we will have some doses that will be set to expire. But because of the ramping up also of our vaccinations in the various areas here in the entire region, I believe and we are upbeat and positive that we will be able to use them and utilize these vaccines as given to us.
Dr. Loretta, when you say there are some doses that may expire come July, how much are we talking about here? How many doses?
I do not have the numbers yet because there has to be an inventory, but definitely for the month of June, we do not have any vaccine doses from all brands that will expire by June 30.
All right. Thank you for joining us today. We're going to have to leave it at that. Dr. Mary Jean Loretta there, DOH Central Visayas spokesperson. We appreciate you coming to the show. Take care and you keep safe.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Magandang araw sa atin.
Magandang araw din po.